I only shoot and score. Then if you score, then we'll come.
All right, boys, we're here. I just woke up. I might be sounding a bit weird, but yeah, I'm a bit tired. But hey, Hoot Rivals rewards are here. Oh my god. So hey, I made a choice this year. No untradables. Imagine me getting like great untradables at this point, and then in 2 months, I can't even use them. I want to capitalize everything on coins, so I can maximize my team. Also, gaming world championships probably will be in Hoot again this year, so I need my team ready. Let me tell you, I think 90% of the time, coins is the correct option. 90k coins, that's a shit ton of money. But at the start of the game, I think option 1 is okay, because there's so many cards that have value. Also, because of the team building sets, like even the low overalls, 75s to 80 overalls might be worth something. So, for content, first time I will take option 1. But I think for most of the year I will just take coins. We'll see. First time in NHL 21 I see an ultimate pack. I think you guys saw what ultimate pack did to me last year. Pretty much only put Barkos. I got nothing good from these ones, but 20 items all plus 80 overall at the start of the game. This pack is like totally ridiculous. Even Jumbo Elite pack 11 plus 80 overall players. An NHL player pack 4 plus 80 overall players. So I think at the start, we have to get unlucky to not win money. And there we go, Larkin right away. Mark Stone. Nice, boys, nice. First pack, we already got Stone and Larkin. That's like 20k already. Ooh, nice, you buy it back, let's go. Vegas player. Vegas players, because of the team buildings that are really expensive. People like to do that 85 James Neal. Show me the money. Oh, gold collectible. There we go, boys. We've almost already made our money back. Yeah, okay. I guess I was a bit wrong about the coins. At the start of the game, take the packs. Okay, so gold collectible, Stone, and Larkin. And then we have the ultimate pack. We don't even need much to break even in the coins, but of course we want to see what our first ultimate pack is like. See if our luck has changed at all. Tyson Barry. So every player in this pack is plus 80 overall. Scheifele! Nice, boys. Scheifele is always great in NHL. Always. It's a bit shame he only has 70 faceoffs, because this guy is the perfect center. Okay, lots of 82s to 80s. These guys are not valuable. Two more. Brent Burns from the final. Also, little. Nice, boys. So we got Burns, Scheifele, Larkin, Stone, and a gold collectible. Plus all the other gold players, I think we got way more than 90k. Let's see what the prices are like on the players. If plenty of people have gotten that ultimate pack, I think the market may have dropped a bit. Let's check Malkin, for example, because I have 3 Malkins. So Malkin is 50k. Okay, so the prices haven't dropped yet. I bought Malkin for 40k a couple days back. Then we got McKinnon from the pack a couple days ago. Huh? Seth Jones. Seth Jones might be worth something. Yeah, Heiskanen's rating in Hoot is a joke. In Versus as well. Akkari. Is 68,000? Guys, if you remember last year, the prices of the regular golds were so much higher. But for some reason this year, they're lower. I think last year they didn't have any special packs at the beginning. I think that's what does it. I'm thinking of selling these guys, but I will be really mad if the prices will go up. But the amount of packs EA is putting out, I really think this might be the best time to sell these players. Scheifele 15,000. Oof. Stone 12,000. Actually, Larkin might have been one of the most expensive players. 18k in value. Then let's look at Brent Burns. Burns is 18 as well, okay. Alright, boys, couple tips player-wise. These are the points in my team after 21 games. I still haven't lost the game yet. Nice flex. Of course we know Selanne and Gretzky get it done. But guys, Ansei Kopitar with a speed synergy is unreal. And Artemi Panarin is unreal. These two guys for me have felt at least the same than Gretzky and Selanne. But Kopitar and Panarin play in the second line, so they have less ice time and they have the same amount of points as Gretzky and Selanne. So yeah, just wanted to tell you that those guys are great. Also Couturier, point per game in the third line center. He's actually pretty cheap as well. To close this video off, let's go play some Hoot Rush. I will give you my opinions on the game mode. They've put a lot of effort in the Hoot Rush menus. Let me tell you that. Hoot Rush menus look way cooler than the regular Hoot menus. So if you don't know what Hoot Rush is, in Hoot Rush you play short games and the game gives you objectives of what you need to do. So let's take this Matthews for example. I have to score 5 goals with Austin Matthews, win 5 games, make bank passes, score goals with Toad Rack Deke and perform chip deeks. And then in the Ovechkin you have to perform slip deeks, score top chef goals, score Hoot Rush goals with Ovechkin, make big hits and win games. And reward wise, let me show you for example what I've gotten so far. So it starts with a customization choice pack, some coins, and then some lower overall players. By the way, I have played 19 games of this so far. Then it goes up, tier 9, that's where I'm at. 3 gold players pack, untradeable. 5000 coins is the next step. So the best rewards in the first Hoot Rush, which ends Saturday, is mini players pack and premium pack. And then you can get some coins along the way and order untradeable packs. So not the best, but I think those will get better. For some reason they have reset this Matthews thing. Probably because you got bunch of error codes when you actually wanted to play. But look at the drafting of the Hoot Rush cards. Like, they put so much effort into this. I would have wanted to see the same effort in HUT, like in regular HUT. So yeah, my opinions of Hoot Rush. I hated it at the beginning. And when I heard the idea, I freaking hated it. Like playing games where it doesn't matter if you win or lose. The game just gives you objectives what you need to do. Like, that sounded like a stupid idea for me. But then for some reason, I actually got into this one. For example, if you've played like 5 Rivals games in a row, and you feel like taking a break, you can just go chill in the Hoot Rush. Do stupid objectives. There's no leaderboards. I don't know, I feel like at the end of the day this was a good thing to have in the game. I've enjoyed it more than I thought. Do some stupid objectives and then get rewarded for it. And it doesn't take any time. And you can do other things in the meantime. I'm just so competitive, I still would want to see some type of leaderboard in Hoot Rush. Maybe see a record in Hoot Rush. But thinking of that, I think that may ruin the actual idea of Hoot Rush. I will show you what one game of Hoot Rush looks like. So I had to do some Toad Rack goals, goals with Matthews. Oh, they changed this one. So before this was on the small eyes, now it's in the big eyes. Okay, I guess that's why they reset it. I don't know how those problems can happen in the first place. I don't remember what I need to do. God's sakes. Toad Rack. Toad Rack goals and goals with Matthews at least, so let's do a Toad Rack goal with Matthews, almost. What else? Oh yeah, I had to do bank passes. I don't actually know what counts as a bank pass. I think that has to be it. That has to be the bank pass. You bank it to yourself there. But when you do it, it should pop up in the top right corner as points for doing it. This is a good time to do the bank. There we go. I didn't get points off that one. Really? I don't know, does the game just want me to do a regular pass off the boards? Let's try. No, I didn't get points off that one. Well, what the fuck? Maybe I need to go around somebody? That has to be. Okay, yeah, there you go. Board bank self. Board bank self pass. I got 150 points. Board bank self. Well, what? So I guess the game just has to read that you go around somebody for it to count. Oh, Matthews. There we go. Toad Rack Matthews. Oh. It didn't even say in the top right that I did a Toad Rack. I really hope they counted that. Wait, that has to count. Oh, back pass. Oh, had to try it. That goal didn't count as a Toad Rack deke goal. Excuse me. Where's the respect for my Toad Rack backhander? Oh my. I should have done the Toad Rack there. Nice rin nap. Let's go. Other way. Hamilton. Bank pass. There we go. Got some points. No. No. Oh no, Teemu. Let's take the manual goal. Look at this one. Almost. Oh my god. 2-2. Next goal wins. Alright. There we go. Okay, but that was the Hoot Rush game. I hope you understood what that was about. We got Premium 1 Code Player Pack. Nice. Let's go open that one as well. I'm a bit salty my freaking Toadrack backhander didn't come. Alright, I got one pack of the objectives as well. So we got two untradeable packs where we get the plus 80 player untradeable. Ooh, do we get lucky? Oh, they want to pick. Voracek. Okay, Voracek is okay. He does it with my team, but guess that's a good pull from this kind of pack. Alright boys, there was the video. Hope you enjoyed it. If you enjoyed the content, feel free to subscribe. I saw in my channel stats the last month of view time, like 70% of you were not subscribed. If you don't want to sub, that's alright, but yeah. that just was a weird stat. So yeah, have a great day and see you next time.